Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. On this episode, let's take a look at keyboard shortcuts for save and open dialogs. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So most keyboard shortcuts deal with commands in the menu bar. But when you go to save or open a file, you're presented with a special dialog. And you can use some keyboard shortcuts there too to get through that quicker. So here I've created a document in Pages. I've typed some text but I haven't saved it yet. So I'm going to do Command S, or you could do File Save, and it will be presented with a Save dialog. Now the Save dialog has two modes. This is the compressed mode where you just see the bare minimum, and you can click this little reveal triangle here to look at the full mode. It doesn't matter which one of these we use because the keyboard shortcuts are pretty much the same. First one I'm going to show you is how to cancel. If you don't want to do whatever the action is for the dialog, like open or save, or it could be something else like printing, you can use the cancel button. But the keyboard shortcut for that is either the escape key, or you could use command period to trigger the cancel button. Now if you want to actually save, then you can of course click the save button. But if you want to do it by the keyboard, you can just hit the return key. The return key by default is going to do the default action. In this case, the button that's in the bright blue color. Now notice that text is selected in the save as field for typing. So I can type a name and then hit return to save, all without having to touch the mouse or trackpad. Now there's a variation on the save dialog, and that's when you go to close something you haven't saved yet. So for instance, I go to file close or use command W, and I get save and cancel as before, except now I also get a delete button. Now in some apps that button says don't save. When it says don't save, you can use command D to activate don't save, but you can also use command delete to do it. When it's a delete button, it seems like only command delete works. So if I want to close this document and never save it, I can use command and then press the delete key on the keyboard, and it's the same as pressing that delete button on the screen. Now you can navigate around to different folders in the save dialog using the same keyboard shortcuts you use in the finder. So see here where it says desktop, I could do command shift O and it changes to documents. Where did command shift O come from? Well, if I go to the finder here, there's a go command, and you could see all these keyboard shortcuts. Command shift O for documents, D for desktop, L for downloads, H for home, C for computer, etc. So I can get to any of these folders the same way. So for instance, if I wanted to go to the home folder, it's command shift H. I go back into Pages here, command shift H takes me to my home folder. This also works in open dialog. So if I want to go file open, I can do command shift H to go home, command shift O to go to documents. Note that you could also use command up arrow to move up in the hierarchy. So say I moved up from the iCloud Drive documents folder to iCloud Drive. If I were to go to say the home folder and go down into pictures, I could do command up to go up. Works the same in save dialogs. There I am on my home folder. I can do command shift O for documents, command up arrow to go up one level. Now other finder keyboard shortcuts work as well. So here I am in an open dialog, and you see I can actually switch to icon or column view instead of list view here. In the finder, view, icon, list, and columns correspond to command 1, command 2, command 3. So I can go back into Pages here and do command 1, command 2, command 3, and you could see those work as well. Lots of other finder shortcuts work here as well. Now if you really like using the keyboard, you can actually type the name of the path. All you need to do is use one of two keys, either the slash key, type that, and notice instead of entering it in the name field there, it automatically uses this go to folder field here, and you could start typing a path name starting with the top level of your drive, which you would normally start with a slash. Now instead of that I can do the tilde, which on American keyboards is shift and then the key just to the left of the one. And then I get a little tilde there. So then I can start typing a path that's relative to my home folder. So I would do a slash after that and then start typing something like, say, the Documents folder. Now I can use autocomplete as well by pressing Tab, and it will try to autocomplete in a similar way to how the terminal does it. So for instance, if I tried to do D and then autocomplete, it would give me a selection of stuff because there are several different folders that start with D. But if I did DOC and then hit Tab, it would automatically go to Documents because it's the only thing that could match that. So you could quickly type path names here and then hit Go, and it changes the where to be that location. So what about other buttons? If I were to do Command S for Save and it's an expanded dialog here, for instance, I have a new folder button. How do I get to that? Or what if I go to a dialog that has a lot of stuff in it, like I'll do Command P for Print, and there are a bunch of buttons in here. I can tab between elements. Now notice what's going to happen is I'm going to tab and it's only going to go to fields I could type in. So right now I'm in the number of copies. I tab and it's from, and then tab again and it's to, and it just goes between those. However, in System Preferences you can change this. Go to Keyboard and then Shortcuts, and there's a selection here for Full Keyboard Access. Turn that to All Controls. Notice that Control F7 allows you to toggle this. So now that it's All Controls, when I tab it goes to everything, every little button in this dialog. So if I wanted to do something like, for instance, use the Hide Details button, I could get to that button and then hit the space bar to activate it. Same thing if I did Command S. If I wanted to get to the new folder now, I could tab to it. Notice it goes to every element. And eventually I get to New Folder. You see that it's highlighted, and I can use the space bar, and now I can create a new folder. In this dialog, by the way, I can also use Command Period or Escape to cancel. So using that you could do just about anything in a dialog without ever having to lift your fingers off the keyboard. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.